Welcome the fuck back to Dark Souls 2, everybody. And we are continuing on the journey to complete the playthrough here in episode 29 of DS2. I'm pretty sure I don't need to waste an Ashen Idol here. Oh shit, you can see the face. Nidalia, Bride of Ash. Yes. Okay, so maybe I do want to use an Ashen Idol. I think I'm going to do that. Smelter Wedge. Get the fuck out of here. Oh yeah, we do need that. Y'all hear that? Fucking voice gate light cut off for a second. Oh! Almost just fell to my death. No joke. Alright, well, there's a lot we need to do, but I'm just trying to keep the basic goal in mind, which is to, of course, just kill the bosses that are in this DLC. Dexterity ring. So I'm just trying to figure out an efficient path to get to Fume Knight, then to Smelter 2.0, and then to Sir Alon. I always used to call him Sir Alone, but I don't think his name is Sir Alone because the way it's spelled with the two N's. Sir Alon, maybe. Helifano. So no, we can't go down that way yet. You can hear the whispers and shit. All fucking creepy. If you walk through these things, you can get some loot underneath them every now and then, but I don't know. Oh, this one's got some. Yeah, they're usually just soul packets. Gotta watch out for the Ashen Idols. Son of a bitch. One thing that, like, always, like, man, like, I don't ever understand, like, the design of these guys is, like, look how fucking, like, skinny these guys are. Like, they're fucking little, like, twig men. They're, like, charcoaled, like, twig dudes, and their armor is, like, three times bigger than they are. And yet they're swinging around these giant axes in my face like they're toothpicks. Even though their arms look like toothpicks. Doesn't make much sense, but like, their armor is all, like, a couple sizes big for them. So they're just, they just look a little weird, that's all. But who am I to judge them? Prism Stone. And all the DLC enemies look the same. I mean, they don't obviously look exactly the same, but they all look similar. They're all big, lanky dudes with armor that looks like it's too big for them, and they all carry around giant-ass weapons. You know, they all kind of have, like, the same build when you think about it. Ooh, I don't know if I want to come down here just yet. Oh shit. Good thing I got to using that real quick. That's right, motherfuckers. Ho! Okay. Running in there wasn't the best idea. I mean, not that I would have. I don't know why I thought running in there would have been a good idea. I'm running into a fucking corner, and there's already more enemies in there. What the hell I'm thinking. Alright, let's make our way back. Gotta jump down here. All the way down here. Pretty sure I can just sprint by these dudes. See you later. Okay. I don't think they'll be following me. At least I hope not. If they're following me, then... boy, am I in trouble. But they've got to get down a couple ladders before they can get to me, so... I think I'm good on time. Oh, shit. Like, look how lanky this dude's arms are. Look at him. But yeah, he's one-handing those giant axes, which I imagine are pretty heavy. Like, they could at least gave him some muscle mass. You know? Maybe I'm just overthinking it. I guess it doesn't really matter either way. And yeah, another thing, like, I really wanted to, like, get Dark Souls 2 finished so I can get a jump on DS3 so I can play the DLC for Dark Souls 3, the new one, when it comes out, which I think it either comes out this month or sometime in April. I'm not entirely sure, because I want to get DS3 main game finished and recorded, and then get the DLC uploaded around the time that the DLC is released, so I'm kind of like not late to the party, if you know what I'm saying. What's in here? Okay, that's what's in there. Explodey dudes. What? Forgot, illusory walls don't open with a fucking hitting them anymore. You have to press a button. Am I alone? I'm alone. 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 Let's crack this bad boy. What you got? Useless, and what else? Soul vessel. Oh shit, what's up there? Huh. Didn't even realize there was like a way to look down in there. Lloyd's talisman, oh my god, look at all the people who just died right there. What we got in here? Any items? Mundane stone, two of them. Interesting. It's always a good idea to check those dust mounds. I don't know what I was thinking when I did that. I don't know what was going through my mind. Run, 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 run. Yeah, run. How are you not... okay, I was gonna say, how are you guys not blowing up? How have you not blown up? And believe me, I do want to do Bloodborne on the channel as well. But... I have to hook my PS4 up, and that would take... a little bit of time to do. It's not as convenient as playing on PC when it's just all the games you want to play are on one device. Just click and play, boom, hook up a controller, you're all set. Instead of having to like bring in another console into my room, hook that up, hook it up with OBS, etc., etc. It's just a little easier on PC. And then you get all the benefits of playing on PC. Which is like the better graphics, performance, and all that jazz. Get a bonfire right here, perfect. We're making our way through, we're making our way. No problem. So that goes down there. Okay. We are getting ever so close to that smelter demon, to Fume Knight. We're getting closer. Inch by inch. Going down to this big room is going to be the next step. Yeah, none of this stuff works yet until we put the scorching iron scepter in its place. Oh, hey there, buddy. Okay, one of you is going to pop up, right? Or not, okay. I'm okay with that. And then you fools are in here. Why don't you come over here? Oh, actually, you know what? I think if we pull out a torch, they run away from us. So let's do that. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's break all these. Because I want them to go down there to wander around and try to weaken the smelter giant. Because if the smelter giant, if he gets like lava on him, out of one of his shoulder things, it'll blow up. And it'll do damage to him. Which is less damage that we have to do to him down there. Will you take your dumbass? There you go. Okay, they're all down there. Huh. Cause once I jump down there, that bride of ash, the ashen idol thing is gonna give everything in there a buff. So I don't want that to happen. Do I have fire arrows? That is the question. I do. How perfect. Hit boxes. Ah. There we go. I guess I'll just take them all out. What? Hey, you fucked up, buddy. You have fucked up now. Can I throw an alluring skull? I wonder if an alluring skull would work in this situation. Ladies and gentlemen, could an alluring skull actually be useful? For once, let's find out. Looks like it won't be. Okay. Shouldn't have expected anything else. Yeah, 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 yeah. This way. Stay right there. Stay right there. Oh, yeah, bring your big friend over. Stand right there. Just stay right there, dude. This might take a while. If he'll get poisoned. Oh, he's poisoned, alright. He's poisoned, alright. Poison arrows. Still proving to be one of the most clutch items in Dark Souls 2. For when DS2 throws bullshit at you, you can throw it right back at him. Okay, he's moving out of the way. Smart. But you can't hide from the inevitable. Death comes. Just like Reaper always says. So that should burn through the rest of his health, I want to say. We'll hit him a couple more times, and then we should be free to go down there without any major worries. Because I see one goon. Two goons, you're up there, so you're not too big of a threat. The smelter giant was the biggest threat. Okay. Oh shit, firebomb. Look at this asshole. Oh my god. Apparently you can like... You can like hit back firebombs. Or something like that, I don't know. I don't think now is the best time to try. What? Blow up. Oh wait, why am I trying to get him to blow up when I just go like this? There we go. That's what I should have done. Silly me. How did you... Oh. Yeah, and you also need to stop doing that, like, right now. She's like, oh, what's that? Oh, shit. And she just vanishes into nothing. And I, did I get the other Bride of Ash? I should have three. Okay, I do have three. So we're good. We're good. There's some dialogue that gets said, but you have to, like, get the raw audio files to be able to hear that shit, so I don't even know why they bothered. Get wrecked. Don't come back to life. Or you shall meet the same fate. Okay. Moving on. Oh, these things. These fucking things. These fume sorcerers are annoying as fuck. And I am one hit. Oh, that was close. That was a close one. Because you never know when they're going to do that long duration one or just a quick little one zap thing. I don't know if there's a way to... And then they teleport behind you. And try to backstab you. Like that. Just fucking creepy as shit. Goodbye. Kit one shot, do that counter damage, is OP. GG. Human effigies. Human effigy. Okay. Don't want to drop down there all the way. I think we're near the foyer. Which is over here. And there's a bonfire, so I'm just gonna grab it. I don't think there's anything too important over there that we need to grab. Unless these dudes just wanna go at it real quick, then by all means, let's do it. Oh shit. Oh shit. If that would have just killed me, I would have been ooh, extremely upset. Okay, let's go to the bonfire. I think that's a good thing to do. Not take any more chances, shall we? There we go. Boom, bonfire lit. And we'll take a rest in the foyer. Perfect. Now to get the Scorching Iron Scepter, we have to head off in a certain direction. And I don't think it's It might be this way. Yeah. This makes more sense that it's this way. Based on from what it looks like when we walk into this whole DLC. Oh yeah, we're heading the right direction. This looks familiar. Because we need to get the Scorching Iron Scepter to be able to access Smelter Demon, to access pretty much all the bosses. You need the Iron Scepter, so. Hey, doesn't this go down? There we go. Kill that bitch. Kill that bitch. Why don't you kill that bitch? Let's open this up. Ooh, it does. Okay. Well, hello. Ouch. Oh, hello. As soon as they do that, you always gotta be ready for them to be right behind you, ready to poke you in the ass. And then actually right here, if I have any regular fire bombs, what was that? Okay. Big ass random explosion. We get this guy to go over here. And for him to stand right in front of that wall. Yeah, 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 yeah. And then we do that. They give us a black firebomb back for, I think, doing it correctly, and then in here we get 8 petrified dragon bones. I was gonna say, you seem to have trapped me here. And then there's another hidden wall, on one of the sides here. Which you can also use the barrel guys to open. Oh, there's 2 of you bitches. Oh shit. Come here. Oh shit. That did a lot of fucking damage. Send that back that way. Yeah, it's right here. You just get him to stand in front of this and then you send the ye olde, oh my god, I did not expect him to hit me. The hell was that? Oh, he's coming full blast. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? I didn't even need to run all that way. God damn it. If you even roll through that stuff, it doesn't even fucking prevent you from taking a shit ton of damage. Right, I see how it is. I see how it's gonna be, game. Blow up. Oh, fuck. Yeah, you wanna fucking die, thank you. Barrel dudes are surrounding me on all sides. Oh shit! Okay. Trying to get my shit together here. You're dead. Damn, that shit is relentless. Oh my god! Drink an Estus. Like your life depends on it. Okay. I was gonna say, last time this dude hit me through the fucking wall. Oh, thank god he didn't follow up there. I would've been fucked. Ooh. The fighter shoulders, they alternate. So you just keep that in mind, and then no problem. He shall fall. Alright, let's raise this last one up. And we'll raise this one. He's like, oh, I gotta pull this lever down. Gotta get a good grip on it. Gotta take a couple minutes, 10 minutes to pull down the lever. I'm gonna break all these barrels. Yeah, basically a strat would be like, get that big dude to come over here, throw a firebomb on this, and they all go kablammo. And it does a lot of damage to the big guy. Oh shit, what is this? The hell? I don't remember this. Then again, there are a lot of things I don't remember. What is this? A dried root? Oh, is this just a shortcut? Please tell me it's a shortcut. Hurrah for shortcut, okay. Nice. A blessing in disguise. We take those. On we go. Cross another big ass chain. Just like we did when we came in. Alright, now we're. The only reason we're here now is for the scorching iron scepter. The good old iron scepter is what we need. Oh, you're ugly ass. Oh no. Oh, I was really hoping you wouldn't light yourself on fire like that. Gotta be careful for those torches. Those will, do damage to you. Yeah, those guys are ticking time bombs. If you do not kill them fast enough, they will go ultra rage mode. And explode. I think one-shotting you. Oh my fucking god, will you just not do that? Oh! My god. That was a close one. Get all of these lit up. And this is where we're gonna fall back from. Like, that's where the this portion of the level will end. Just kinda keep you in the loop. How everything eventually wraps around on itself, such as Dark Souls will do. So we'll go all the way down here. I'm not sure if the... Yeah, this is the Quicksword Rachel. This is where we can get a cheese on her. Which is a... It's a really funny cheese. Which, okay, maybe I shouldn't try and go for the cheese. Okay, now I think I'm good. So you can just basically get yourself to burn to death. Just by kind of doing a little bit of this action. And then you just kind of chill out. Shout out to Lobos Jr. for this cheese idea. If you don't know who Lobos Jr. is and you're into Souls stuff, I highly suggest you check out his YouTube and his Twitch. Guy is amazing. Starting to catch on to us, huh? Nope. She's like, I'll get to you eventually. So long as I just don't keep getting burned. Ouch, 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 ouch. Yeah, you could literally just do that all day. Especially if you're doing like a no-death run. And you're just trying to play it extra safe. Even though if you're doing a no-death run, I don't know why the hell you'd even bother coming through the DLC. I'm actually trying to play it safe as well. Get over here. What the hell are you doing? Reapply your resin. I think that's, is that a poison resin? Looks like poison. You're not very quick for someone whose name is Quicksword Rachel. Any day now. Tick, 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 tick. Burn, motherfucker, burn. And GG. Oh, I was trying to light my goddamn torch. Guess not. Alright. Alright. That is death. For sure. Oh, kill your friend. Or just blow yourself up or something. Do not crawl at me like that. That is horrifying. Thank you. Oh, shit. He lit up the torch. That was actually kind of dope. I think this is the door we want to go down anyways. I hope I am not mistaken. Oh, and I don't think I was. Ooh, yeah, yeah. So, basically, here's the deal. We've got alluring skulls. We're gonna need those. Because once we take the scepter, they're all gonna get very angry at us. It's a very Dark Souls thing to do. Or we could do it the other way. Which I think what you could do is you take it, you throw a... Or right before you take it, you throw an alluring skull, and then you grab it, and then they're all occupied on the alluring skull. Which I actually want to try and throw one now and see what happens. Alright, I want to try something else. I want to equip a firebomb. Throw the firebomb. All of you blow up on the alluring skull. Oh! Go for the alluring skull. Thank God. Okay, there's one. Go for that one, buddy. stay over there. There they go. And I think that's all of them. Okay, cool. Alluring Skulls for the win. We'll take that Scorching Iron Scepter. Shove it right in our pocket. Ooh, I heard that. Why is your bounce so powerful? Ooh. Yeah, and this is also where they try to dick you. You're like, oh, I'm about to get out of here. I'm being chased by all these things. You're like, I'm waiting for the elevator. Where's the elevator? Where is it? And then they leave a surprise for you on the elevator. Not a very friendly surprise. You think like an item or something, or I don't know, an NPC, but they try to kill you to death. Yes, they try to kill you to death. Makes all the sense. Then we fall back down here, and we're right back where we started. Bada bing. We got the Scorching Iron Scepter. And we're going to go back to the foyer. We'll place the scepter. And that'll be it for the episode. This episode went a little longer, which is okay, but we made progress. Our first episode in the DLC, and we're getting the Scorching Iron Scepter. And placing it. And this whole place is now churning with life. Just like that. Alright, cool. Well, I'm going to end this episode here. Like I said, hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you didn't get too cold in this video. Because it's been the dead of winter, as always, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Leave a comment if you got one. Next episode, we're going to go make our way towards Fume Night. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. As always, we'll see you in the next one. We'll be right back.